I don't like it. We can't trust Comyn.
It's sacred ground, Angus.
I still don't like it.
Well, he insisted.
I confess I was surprised to receive your letter. I do urgently desire to discuss with you a matter most delicate. It's a bit cryptic, wouldn't you say?
It was intentional.
I see. And if I were to infer that your aim was in fact to reignite a rebellion, we already tried it for 8 bloody years and we failed.
Because we didn't unite?
No. Because your family were too busy trying to claim a crown that wasn't theirs. Are you saying you wish to relinquish that claim?
I'm saying we need to set aside our rivalry and win back our country. Then we can decide who wears the crown. Us. Not Edward. John, between us, we could raise 20,000 men. We could have a fighting chance.
It'll never work. The people are tired of war and suffering.
Wallace was tortured and slaughtered. The people aren't tired. They are desperate for justice.
Wallace got what he deserved. He wasn't a man. He was an idea. A destructive and dangerous idea. Almost as dangerous as the idea you're proposing.
You Bruces are all the same, John.
You're not worthy of our country. And I swear I'll do whatever it takes to keep you from being its king. And once I explain to Edward the meaning of your furtive letter to me, we'll place a noose over your head and Scotland's crown upon mine.